I would say that I'm born and raised in the city of Youngstown, educated in Youngstown. I hold both my bachelor's, my master's, and my honorary doctorate from Youngstown State University. Prior to becoming mayor, I was the deputy treasurer at the Mahoning County Treasurer's Office, and I did that for about 10 years. The pandemic is the number one challenge we're facing. Although, you know, we're getting the vaccinations and people are getting tested, the numbers are still going up. The variants are out there. And the one thing I continue to stress that I don't want us to come out and just survive. I want us to thrive. You know, it's an interesting question you say, you know, why you want to be mayor. I took an oath 4 years ago and I said I wouldn't cave to money, power, and politics, and I would put Youngstown residents first. And over the last three years, 4 months and 16 days, I've been able to keep that promise. One of the things I had to do to come into this job, I restored integrity back to City Hall. We were missing integrity. We are now at the table at the state and the national level, and we had not been at the table because of some ills of the past. And also, we've been building partnerships that we didn't have. We're building partnerships with city and township just in the immediate area. And those that we had relationships, we would strengthen. But those we didn't, we're building those relationships, both bipartisan as well. For us, the $88.6 million, the ARP dollar is going to be a game changer. It's going to be a legacy opportunity for us. Those are some of the pieces that we're going to be able to put in place that will not only affect my children, but it will affect my grandchildren going down in the near future. We have till 2024 to spend those dollars. But I think one of the things I make sure that I say this and time again, we need a comprehensive plan that's going to involve everyone from the citizens to our community partners, the city council, the mayor's office. We've got to have all hands on deck. Everyone has an idea of how to spend the money. We want to come together as a team and have a comprehensive plan to do so. And I want to make sure that we have someone who's a compliance officer who makes sure that this $88.6 million is actually going to be spent the right way. I was one of few people who had a one-on-one with then presidential candidate Joe Biden. And when one of the things he said, well, Mayor, what would you like to see? I said, don't forget about places like Youngstown, Ohio. And he said, the mayors will have a seat at the table. In the next 10 years, I see Youngstown, if we can stay on the consistent path of where we're right now, where we're creating a workforce for the 21st century, where we talk about renewable energy for sun, for solar, electric, and we need to make sure that if we're there, I think we're in the middle of a new industry. I think, you know, GM offering another electric battery plant is going to be a big piece for us. But also, we've got to be able to attract those business that want to come to the Midwest because we have the low cost of living. Housing is not bad. It's a great place to buy a home. I think we're going to be in a new industrial revolution with the university expanding, Eastern Gateway Community College expanding. I think this is going to be a place people are going to say, well, what happened and what's changing? And here it is. It's because the team of rivals that used to didn't talk to one another before, they're all working together. And I think the more we work together, the more we're going to be a benefit to the future. And I think that's going to be the key piece, because we're all going to say with one voice and one ask, we're going to go to Columbus and ask for monies or dollars or federal, here talk about projects. We're going to go to D.C. with one voice, one ask. And the main benefit is going to be, how does it benefit the city of Youngstown in the future?